Beneath the waves, hidden from our eyes, lies a world of breathtaking beauty and mystery. With vibrant colors, diverse shapes, and intricate structures, coral reefs have long captivated the hearts and minds of people around the world. But beyond their striking appearance lies a complex ecosystem filled with amazing creatures and hidden secrets waiting to be discovered. Welcome to the secret life of coral reefs, where a kaleidoscope of marine life thrives in symbiotic harmony. Coral reefs are robust underwater ecosystems brimming with life. They are composed of colonies of tiny living animals known as polyps, which secrete a hard protective skeleton of calcium carbonate. Over thousands of years, these skeletons accumulate, resulting in the formation of massive reef structures. These reefs serve as a habitat for an incredible diversity of marine species, making them similar to the rainforest of the seas. While coral reefs are largely associated with warm, clear waters of tropical and subtropical regions, their distribution is actually far more extensive. They span a vast geographic range extending from the eastern coast of Brazil and Africa to the western coast of Central America and Australia. They are also found in the Indian Ocean, encircling islands such as the Maldives and Seychelles, and the Pacific Ocean around areas like Micronesia and Polynesia. This broad distribution is due to the different types of coral reefs. Coral reefs are classified into three primary types: fringing reefs, barrier reefs, and atolls. Fringing reefs, the most common type of reef, grow near the coastline around islands and continents. They extend out to sea like an underwater fringe, hence the name. They are separated from the shore by narrow, shallow lagoons and often form on rocky coastlines where fast-growing coral species can anchor and grow. Barrier reefs also run parallel to coastlines but are separated by deeper, wider lagoons. They are named barrier due to their capacity to obstruct the ocean's waves, creating a calm and protected body of water towards the shore. The Great Barrier Reef in Australia is the most famous example, extending over 2,300 kilometers. Atolls are usually circular or oval in shape with a central lagoon. Atolls are often formed when islands surrounded by fringing reefs sink into the sea, or the sea level rises around them. The coral continues to grow upward from the original fringing reef, maintaining its position relative to the sea surface. The Maldives is a group of atolls in the Indian Ocean and represents one of the most vast and spectacular atoll formations worldwide. Each of these types of reefs has its unique characteristics and marine life, contributing to the rich diversity of the world's coral reef ecosystems. The formation of coral reefs is a slow and fascinating process that begins with a single polyp. A coral polyp is a tiny, soft-bodied organism related to the sea anemones and jellyfish. When a polyp attaches to a rock on the seafloor, it begins to divide. Or when a group of polyps start to work together, a colony is born. As these polyps multiply, they form a colony that continues to expand. The polyps produce a hard, protective limestone skeleton around their bodies, which forms the structure of the coral reef. Over time, either months or even centuries, these limestone skeletons accumulate and fuse together to form the intricate, robust structures we recognize as coral reefs. The overall process is slow, with growth rates usually around 1 to 2 centimeters per year. However, some species of coral can grow at a much faster rate when conditions are optimal. There are essentially two ways that coral colonies grow: one, through asexual reproduction, and two, through sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction occurs when new polyps bud off from parent polyps to form a new colony, thereby expanding the size of their existing colony. This type of reproduction results in identical coral clones, which share the same genetic composition. Corals can also grow asexually through fragmentation, where parts of coral break off and settle in a new area, forming a new colony. Sexual reproduction, on the other hand, takes place once a year in an event known as coral spawning. During this event, corals release their eggs and sperm into the water at the same time. The eggs and sperm join to form larvae, which float in the ocean currents for days or even weeks. Eventually, these larvae settle down onto a hard surface and develop into new coral polyps, making the birth of a new coral colony. This method of reproduction fosters genetic diversity within the coral population, enhancing their adaptability to changing environmental conditions. The spectacle of coral spawning is one of nature's most magical and awe-inspiring events. Life within coral reefs is an explosion of color, diversity, and complexity. Although coral reefs occur on only 1% of the ocean floor, these underwater metropolises are bustling with activity, with an estimated 25% of all marine species calling coral reefs their home. Each organism in this intricate web of life plays a crucial role, contributing to the overall health and functioning of the reef. The coral colonies themselves act as the architects of the reefs, building complex structures that offer shelter to countless creatures. Fish of all shapes, sizes, and colors dart among the coral branches, some grazing on algae, others preying on smaller organisms. The nooks and crannies of the reef are home to a diverse array of smaller organisms. Tiny crustaceans, mollusks, and worms inhabit the reef floor, while larger creatures such as sea turtles, sharks, and rays glide through the water above. Even at night, the reef is alive with activity. Nocturnal creatures such as lobsters and eels emerge from their daytime hideaways to hunt, while bioluminescent organisms add a magical glow to the underwater landscape. Coral reefs are particularly known for their fish diversity. They host a countless number of fish species, each with unique adaptations suited for life in the reef. Clownfish, butterflyfish, anglerfish, parrotfish, and surgeonfish are just a few examples of the vibrant fish species that inhabit these ecosystems. These fish play varying roles, serving as grazers, predators, and cleaner species. For instance, parrotfish are crucial in controlling the growth of algae on the reef and contributing to sand production through their feeding habits. Reefs also house an abundance of invertebrate species, including sea anemones, sea urchins, crustaceans, and mollusks. These creatures, though often overlooked, play essential roles in maintaining the reef's health and balance. For example, sea urchins help control algae growth, while crustaceans like shrimp and crabs contribute to the reef's cleanup crew, scavenging on dead organisms. Invertebrates also provide a vital source of food for other reef inhabitants, ensuring the reef's natural food chain remains intact. On a larger scale, coral reefs attract various species of sea turtles, which use the reefs as feeding grounds. Similarly, different species of sharks and rays, known as the apex predators of the ocean, patrol the reefs, maintaining the balance of the ecosystem by regulating the populations of their prey. One of the most fascinating aspects of life in coral reefs is the multitude of symbiotic relationships that exist. Coral reefs would not be able to thrive without these partnerships where organisms rely on each other for survival. For example, the relationship between corals and zooxanthellae algae is crucial to the reef's survival. These tiny photosynthetic organisms live within coral's tissue, giving corals their vibrant colors. This relationship is mutually beneficial. The coral provides the algae with a safe environment and compounds necessary for photosynthesis. In return, zooxanthellae supply the coral with oxygen and help remove wastes. Most importantly, they provide coral with organic products of photosynthesis, which are used to synthesize proteins, fats, carbohydrates, and calcium carbonate, which is used to build the coral skeleton. This harmonious relationship enables corals to grow and reproduce in nutrient-poor waters. Despite their stunning beauty and biodiversity, coral reefs are not resistant to diseases. Several environmental stressors, such as pollution, climate change, and overfishing, can make coral reefs more susceptible to diseases, like white band disease and black band disease. These diseases can have devastating effects on coral populations and the ecosystems they support. Coral bleaching is another severe condition that is not a disease per se, but a stress response to adverse environmental conditions, such as increased sea temperatures. It occurs when the symbiotic relationships between corals and their zooxanthellae is disrupted, causing the corals to expel the algae and turn white, or bleached. Without the essential nutrients provided by the zooxanthellae, the bleached corals become weakened and more prone to disease. One of the most significant threats to coral reefs is climate change, which leads to warmer ocean temperatures and ocean acidification. Warmer ocean temperatures can cause coral bleaching. Ocean acidification, due to higher levels of carbon dioxide, makes it difficult for corals to build their calcium carbonate skeletons, inhibiting their growth and making them more susceptible to damage. Another major threat to coral reefs is pollution. This comes in many forms, from land-based sources like agriculture runoff and untreated sewage, to marine-based sources like oil spills and plastic debris. These pollutants can harm or kill the corals directly or lead to disease outbreaks. Overfishing and destructive fishing practices such as cyanide fishing or blast fishing also pose significant threats to coral reefs by disrupting the balance of the ecosystem and destroying the physical structure of the reefs. Lastly, coastal development and tourism-related damage can adversely impact coral reefs. Construction activities can lead to increased sedimentation, which smothers corals and blocks sunlight. Activities related to tourism, like snorkeling and diving, if not managed properly, may cause physical damage to the reefs or introduce pathogens. The cumulative effect of these threats has led to a significant decline in coral reefs globally, stressing the urgent need for effective conservation measures. Coral reefs are not just vibrant, diverse ecosystems. They play a crucial role in the Earth's carbon cycle. Through a process called calcification, corals absorb large amounts of carbon dioxide from the surrounding water and convert it into calcium carbonate, which forms their hard skeletons. This process helps to offset the increasing levels of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, which is one of the main drivers of climate change. Coral reefs' ability to sequester carbon dioxide is remarkable, with estimates suggesting that they can capture and store up to 1.2 billion tons of carbon annually. This is equivalent to the emissions from over 200 million cars. Protecting coral reefs therefore not only preserves these incredible ecosystems, but helps to mitigate the impacts of climate change. In addition to their role in the carbon cycle, coral reefs act as natural barriers, protecting coastline communities from the destructive forces of storms and erosion. The complex structure of coral reefs helps to dissipate wave energy, reducing the impact of storm surges and preventing coastal erosion. By acting as a buffer zone, coral reefs can significantly reduce the damage caused by hurricanes, cyclones, and tsunamis, safeguarding both human lives and infrastructure. Plus, coral reefs provide immense economic benefits to local communities and countries. They are major attractions for tourism, drawing visitors from around the world who come to explore the beauty of these underwater ecosystems. Additionally, coral reefs support thriving fisheries that provide sustenance and livelihoods for millions of people. These diverse ecosystems serve as nurseries and habitats for numerous fish species, providing a source of income for local fishermen and ensuring a sustainable supply of seafood. Efforts to conserve and restore coral reefs are being undertaken on both local and global scales. These include direct interventions such as active coral restoration, where fragments of healthy corals are grown in nurseries and then transplanted back on degraded reefs. Efforts are also being made to address the root causes of coral degradation. This involves implementing policies to reduce greenhouse gas emissions, manage coastal development, and regulate fishing practices. Marine protected areas have been established in numerous regions to safeguard critical reef habitats from destructive human activities. Scientists are investigating the resilience of corals and exploring ways to breed super corals that are more resistant to the hostile conditions brought about by climate change. They are also studying the social and economic benefits of coral reefs to help communicate their value and the importance of their conservation to a wider audience. On an individual level, we can contribute to coral reef conservation by reducing our carbon footprint, using reef-safe sunscreens, supporting sustainable seafood choices, and advocating for the protection of these vital ecosystems. As we peel back the layers of the ocean's depths, the true marvels of coral reefs comes into focus. They are not just a static backdrop in the vast expanse of the sea. They are a bustling hub of marine life, a vibrant array of biodiversity, and a testament to the intricate and interconnected nature of life beneath the waves. Thank you for joining us on this journey into the secret life of coral reefs. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and give us a thumbs up. Until next time, keep exploring.